The ITIL Priority Matrix is a valuable way to assign and direct work in an IT service management environment. It can help you understand what is causing the most pain to your end users and direct your support efforts accordingly. Done well, a priority matrix can decrease service downtime, improve customer and employee experience, and make the request and change processes more efficient. So what is a priority matrix? In its simplest form, the priority matrix defines the importance of an incident for the service desk analyst so that they know how quickly it needs to be acted on and enable them to set an expectation with the customer on potential resolution timings. The ITIL matrix balances the impact and urgency of the customer contact so that it can be assigned, communicated, and resolved appropriately. This ITIL methodology is typically used to prioritize incident requests, problems, and change activity in a practical, consistent, and fair way. When dealing with priority matrices, the first thing you need to be familiar with is their terms. They organize incidents, requests, problems, and change based on two factors. Impact is generally the severity of the fault. For example, how much downtime or how many end users are affected. Urgency is how quickly the fault needs to be resolved. So, for instance, if you have an incident where a service is down and people need to use it immediately versus a system where it's down but no one is planning to use it until the following day, the first incident has greater urgency. Most ITSM tools have a priority matrix embedded in their process workflows, so assigning a priority is included in the incident or request logging process. Most practitioners use a scale of 1 to 5, whereby 1 is a critical or major incident and 5 is a minor request or a nice-to-have. When designing any ITSM practice, you need to ponder the pros and cons of using this methodology to route work. Some advantages of using a priority matrix are higher service availability levels because critical incidents and the resources needed to resolve them will be addressed first. Clarity around what incidents and requests should be dealt with first, making sure that everyone is dealt with fairly. Transparency is crucial from an end-user perspective and can help manage expectations. The ability for service desk analysts to break down complex issues and assign an overall priority, empowering support teams to objectively and unambiguously rank priorities. The ability to identify and communicate the most crucial area of focus. Greater transparency between IT and the business. However, everything has a downside. Depending on your organization, there may be circumstances whereby a priority matrix might not be the best possible choice, for example, with dealing with VIP customers. Plus, if the matrix is too rigid, you may miss opportunities for improving customer and/or employee experience. When introducing an ITIL priority matrix, the following best practices can help you do it more effectively. Create the right culture. Set the scene with your support teams and explain how the priority matrix works in your organization. Practice makes perfect. Have a pilot or trial using it beforehand to iron out any glitches. And have it signposted in your service desk portal. Embed it in your tool so that analysts can quickly and easily assign the priority without having to switch screens. Keep your terminology consistent even across different ITSM practices. Review and improve over time. Include your suppliers in your matrix decisions to avoid issues during the fix activity. We all see things differently, and what might be a high priority to your company might be of low priority in the eyes of a third-party supplier. Make sure you agree on priority levels and that this is referenced in any contracts or support agreements. Incident management is all about speed, so it makes sense that incident prioritization is a vital part of the process. A typical ITIL incident priority matrix will look like the following. As you can see, there are 3 levels of impact and 3 levels of urgency, and combining them gives 5 potential priority scores, which will help triage incidents effectively. Incident management priorities should be linked to service levels so that the most critical incidents are resolved first, and support for this is codified in a service level agreement. Problem management is all about root cause analysis. It is the practice of identifying the primal cause of one or more incidents and fixing them, either through the workaround route or by implementing a permanent solution. Thus, the primary input to problem management will be incidents and major incidents. So the problem management priority matrix should be the same as what is already in place for incident management. Sometimes this will mean prioritizing problems not to be solved. For example, if an effective workaround is already in place or a permanent fix is too expensive. Request management is all about fulfilling service requests. It's less pressurized than incident or problem management, as nothing is broken or on fire, but it is the process that links users to new technology, which is a key enabler. Incident and request management are two sides of the same coin. Incident management removes blockers in the form of incidents, and request management drives the business forward with new tools and services, and thus the ITIL Request Priority Matrix should reflect this. Change management, or change enablement if you've embraced ITIL 4, is the practice of delivering IT change effectively, efficiently, and safely. It is the practice that looks at potential change activity, ensuring the activity is in the business's best interests, and then planning and scheduling accordingly. With this in mind, the priority matrix can be adapted for change management so that approvers can assess the impact and urgency of the change in the same way service desk technicians use it to triage incidents or order equipment to make approval and scheduling decisions. Do you have insights on this topic you'd like to share? Please leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to InfGate Academy for more insights into the world of service management.